My name's Scooter LaForge, and this painting is the one I picked. It's probably so typical and so boring and so like everyone's seen it a million times and so commercial. So, you know, it's almost like McDonald's logo or, you know, Mickey Mouse or, you know, it's ingrained in all of our heads. But I picked it for a lot of different reasons. First of all, you know, when you look at it, we don't think, oh, that's a painting of sunflowers in a vase. You look at it and you say, oh, that's Vincent van Gogh. You know, that's the first thing that comes into people's heads. And, you know, the reason I identify a lot with Vincent van Gogh from the studies that I've done about him is because he was a mess and he was fucked up. And I'm very fucked up and I'm a mental mess too. And all of his anxieties and depressions and desperations and the need for, you know, attention, I can relate to. And that, you know, just from reading his letters and his behavior, I can relate to. So, I love flowers, and I do a lot of painting of still lifes of flowers. And this painting in particular is very dynamic. And what I love about it is the composition and how he squashed all of these flowers together. And then you just have a plain yellow background. This painting was painted in, 1888, and he started painting in 1880, and then he died in 1890. So I think he had a span of painting for like near 10 years, and one thing I love about him is that he just never stopped painting. He just always painted, and there's beautiful paintings like this one, and there's some ugly paintings, there's ugly drawings, there's gorgeous drawings, but he never stopped. And you know, that was something that I really admire, that he just kept going. And he has thousands of paintings that his brother Theo's wife collected, and if it wasn't for her, they wouldn't be famous. You know, she was the one that really put his star on the map. He wanted this to look like a stained glass window. And this yellow was a new kind of artificial color that was on the market during that era. They just started kind of making these tubes of paint, and he went out and bought these tubes of paint and, you know, made this. So it's just really yellow and green, and there's a little highlight of blue here. Also, there's seven versions of this, and I think one or two of these he might have painted from a still life, and then he copied his still lifes. This painting in particular, another reason I love it is because he painted it during his stay in Arles, where a friend, not a friend, but somebody who he admired was going to come and stay there and mentor him, Paul Gauguin, which is another painter. And his brother basically paid Paul to go and stay with him and paint with him, which is really nice. Nobody has ever paid for somebody to come and stay with me or paint with me. I mean, that's a luxury. You know, we have this whole thing where he was such a, you know, everyone felt sorry for him, he was alone and this, that, and the other, but I don't think so. I mean, he had somebody who was taking care of him and giving him money. No one in my family has ever sent me money and said, oh, you know, I'm gonna, you know, send over Picasso to come stay with you for the summer and he's gonna paint with you. Like, you know, so I don't necessarily feel sorry for Vincent van Gogh. I mean, he was taken care of and he had somebody who loved him very much. Also, when he died, which was 2 years after he painted this, he had a big, lavish funeral, which I read about, where, you know, all these people, this guy, this famous guy from the avant-garde movement in Paris, came all the way there to be at his funeral, and he had a lot of support from these other painters, and he was getting famous during his lifetime, and you know, before I really started studying about him, I thought he was all alone, I thought he was an alcoholic, I thought he was, you know, just by himself, but he wasn't. And anyways, back to this funeral, he was, during his the funeral, he had his coffin out, and there was all these sunflowers all over his coffin. There was flowers everywhere, and he had his easel set up, and he had his palette there, and he had his painting apron, and there was a lot of people there. And all of his paintings were hanging all over the funeral house, which is really cool. And, you know, I know a lot of artists that have died in my lifetime, and they didn't have kind of funerals of that, you know, that much drama and excitement and beauty. But, you know, I really looked at this painting a lot, and this painting is 27 by 38 inches. And one night, I decided I was gonna copy it and just paint it, because I know he paints really fast. So I went out and bought the stretcher bars, and I adjusted the stretchers in this exact size, and I bought the paints. And I said to myself, I'm gonna see how it feels to paint this painting and see what it's like to put myself in his shoes, just to see what it feels like to paint a Van Gogh painting. I've never done that. And I started it maybe at 9 at night, and, you know, it went by really fast. I didn't stop. I didn't stop painting until maybe 4 in the morning. But I got it done. I couldn't stop painting it. And, you know, there's a really high-res image of this from the Van Gogh Museum that I studied. These here are really built up in oil paint, so I kind of mimicked it as best as I could. And, you know, it made me really happy to paint it.